unwritten rules in the sport for some people. Obviously not for him, and that's fine, you know? And he's just made an entire career off of it, you know? And some people like his music. I personally don't, because I don't believe any of it. And I like to listen to guys that I believe. But
you were a Clips fan. You had the sign mic and all that stuff. So yeah, how did that have that?
I still have it upstairs.
Idols become your rivals, right? And like, I guess to genuinely lose respect for someone.
Yeah, but it's also, you just get to peek behind the curtain too, right? It's like, you know, when I was, whatever, 16, thinking that he was the biggest dope dealer in the world, serving bricks to every corner of America. Yeah, sure, I'm sure I was, you know, again, a fan and obviously more so just a fan of like Pharrell and the Neptunes. I always wanted to be signed to Star Trek and stuff like that. That was like the wave. But yeah, I mean, you know, now that I'm grown up and I actually know him and the truth is just kind of like, I don't know, it's not as appealing as it once was.
Yo, you know what time it is. It's time for a motherfucking blog, niggas. Yo, so peep this. Drake is having an interview with Elliot Wilson from Rap Radar, right? And basically they're still talking about this Pusha T shit. Now, my question to y'all is, do you think Drake is still fucking bitter from this battle? I'm gonna give y'all my opinion, and y'all niggas give me y'all opinion. So I personally feel like, yo, Drake is oozing with bitterness. Drake feels so fucking mad that he lost that battle with Pusha T. Because at one point, you know, after that battle with Meek Mill, Drake was damn near untouchable. You know what I'm saying? Drake was just running through motherfuckers. You know what I'm saying? Everybody knows about the subliminals he took at Jay-Z. Everybody knows the subliminals he took at Diddy. He fucking beat Meek Mill. Now the battle with Pusha T, he lost. He lost. He lost. Fucking Pusha T just outsmarted him, and he just came at him with a whole fire angle, and it just fucked up Drake's whole fucking, you know, rollout for his album. Now, my whole thing is, like, when Drake starts talking about, oh, I'm just not a fan of his music, you know. Some people are into his music because, you know, well, they believe the shit that he does. And me, I just know the behind-the-scenes shit. And, you know, he's just not really about that life. And it's like, my nigga, two slaps, nigga, if you don't knock that shit the fuck off. Because if you want to talk about fucking Pusha T's behind-the-scenes shit, I can't even imagine to fucking, I don't know where to even start with the behind the scenes shit you probably got hidden and covered up, especially with you having the machine behind you. You probably have so many deep, dark secrets about you that is probably crazy if motherfuckers found out, really. They probably wouldn't even be Drake fans. So don't try to like spin it and try to use this whole little angle in your interviews to make motherfuckers be like, yeah, why are you always supporting Pusha? You know, he's not really a drug dealer. Your own pops came out and said, you be fabricating shit about your fucking, you know, your fucking come up with him. How you be lying on him and shit. So, I mean, your own pop said this, bro. So let's not try to like discredit motherfuckers for their, whatever they're talking about in their music when you probably have some crazy skeletons in your closet. And then furthermore, you know, you want to say shit like, I used to be a fan of him and now you're not a fan of him anymore. Bro, keep it a buck. You're not a fan of him because you lost the battle, my nigga. That's why. Don't try to make it seem like it's, oh, you're just not into his music anymore because he's lying. Half of these motherfucking rappers you do collabs with and features with lie in their music. They're not really who they say they are. So don't try to put it on Pusha like, oh, it's just a Pusha thing. Nigga, it's everybody in this motherfucking game is a fucking liar. So two slaps. Ah, shit. But two slaps, nigga. You lying, B. You are a liar. You're mad because you lost. Keep it a buck. You took the L, bro. But do y'all think Drake is bitter? What do y'all think?